Howdy and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be cutting open a prophecy stone. So what is a prophecy stone? Well, let me tell you.
So prophecy stones are a rare mineral from Egypt's Libyan desert, and they're also found kind of in the same area as Libyan desert glass. Prophecy stones are also incredibly unique in that they are a pseudomorph of limonite and hematite after marcasite and pyrite. The original shape remains from a marcasite and pyrite, however, the entire mineral has actually morphed into a limonite and hematite.
So let's go ahead and slap on some gloves and get this thing cut open.
First things first, this particular prophecy stone was donated to the channel during one of my live sales by a customer slash supporter of the channel. So I don't know if they want to have their name said here in the video, so I'm just going to say thank you. You know who you are, and if you want to make yourself known, you're more than welcome to leave a comment in the section down below. I do appreciate the donation so we can get this open to see what's on the inside. So let's not waste any more time. Let's get this cut. Oh gosh, how do I want to do this? Let's go this way. Well, that was a little messier than I expected, but that's okay. Okay, I haven't looked yet. Let's look at this together. Arm around the camera here. There we go. All right. Let's see what we got. Is it red? Okay, let me go wash. Is that just red on the outside? Like iron? Let's go wash this off really quick. 1 second. Okay, so it's been dried, it's been washed. That's what the inside looks like. But I want to clean it up just a little bit more. Not really to take it to a polish, but just to clean up a little bit so we can get a better idea of what the inside looks like. So in order to do that, we're going to go ahead and take it to the 100 grit Expando belt sander. And there's a reason for this. Because I don't know this material all that much. It seems to be kind of... like it seemed kind of dirty to work, and if this is too hard, I don't want to mess up my Nova wheels. So we're gonna use this machine instead. So we're gonna go ahead and turn on the water and turn on the sander. Make sure the sanding belts are straight. Don't do this at home. There we go. Straight-ish anyway. Water. What I'm going to do, since our cutting pattern's going this way, we're going to sand going this way. Go ahead and take it over to the 600 grit wheel. I think it's 600. Might be 400. Either way, it's one of the two. Okay, we're not going for perfection. We're just cleaning it up. So let me go dry it off. All right, so we have the cut side here. This is fresh off the saw. And then we have the side that we sanded down a little bit. And this is off the 100 grit. And then I think it's either 400 or 600 grit. I can't remember which one's on there right now. But still pretty rough, and it actually took a long time to even go through the 100 grit sanding disc, because I think what was happening is this material was actually gunking up the sanding disc, and it was not fully wanting to really sand everything down, and that's why I decided to use this machine instead of my calving machine, just in case of exactly what has happened. I've ran into material similar to this before, where it took a long time to really sand down. This would take a very good polish. However, we're not doing that today. it would require special steps. So I'd probably just use the same machine, go through higher and higher grit stages, and then eventually just probably do some stages by hand before using a high-speed buffer with some metal polishing rouges. Oh my gosh, I can't talk. But yeah. Using those to get a nice shine on this. But again, we're not doing that today. This is just kind of see what was on the inside of it. And now you get to see what's on the inside. Let me know what you think in the comment sections down below.
So I was not expecting this at all. So I was expecting kind of a silvery inside, kind of like a silvery magnet or like steel color. I was not expecting like this brown rhyolite looking patterning on the inside. So it was kind of cool. But let me know what you guys thought in the comment section down below. I always like hearing your opinions and thoughts. And that is going to do it for today. So thank you all for watching. And I will see you guys in the next video. Hawk on.